Hi everyone, today we are going to see what is meant by stone masonry. So stone masonry is similar to the brick masonry. In brick masonry we have brick plus mortar, in stone masonry we have stone plus mortar. Okay, let's start. So stone masonry, we use stone and mortar. Already we saw what is a mortar. It is nothing but cement, sand and water. So stone plus mortar is equal to stone masonry. So stone masonry, it can be classified into two. First one is rubble masonry and second one is ashlar masonry. So rubble masonry, in this stones are of irregular sizes and shapes. In ashlar masonry, the stones are in regular sizes and shapes. So in rubble masonry, we have three types. First one is known as random rubble masonry. Next one is square rubble masonry and the third one is polygon rubble masonry. In random and square rubble masonry, also we have another subdivision of coarse random rubble masonry and uncoarse random rubble masonry. And in square, we have coarse square rubble masonry and uncoarse square rubble masonry. We already know what is mean by a coarse. Coarse in the sense, a single row is known as coarse. So if it is coarse rubble masonry, we have rows 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. If it is uncoarse, it is in a zigzag pattern. We will not have any proper coarse. So let's start with random rubble masonry. So rubble masonry, in the sense, we know the stones are of irregular sizes and shapes. So in random rubble masonry, the first one is uncoarse random rubble masonry. See, in this, the leveling is only done at 60 or 30 centimeters and there is no dressing is done for the stone. Dressing in the sense, making it in a proper shape. And this random rubble masonry of uncoarse is used in compound wall, godowns and unimportant walls. And this is the cheapest stone masonry. Next one is coarse random rubble masonry. In this, stone will be of 5 to 20 centimeter and this will be hammered dressed, and obviously it is mentioned coarse, so it should be equal height in coarse. And one point we have to make, that vertical joint should be scattered so that it can lead to the strength of the brick masonry. So this is the uncoarsed random rubble masonry. See, we don't have any proper course. This is uneven line. So this kind of masonry is known as uncoarsed random rubble, in the sense we have different irregular shapes of stones are arranged. Okay, so this is uncoarsed random rubble masonry. And this one is coarsed random rubble masonry. See, we have first course, second course, third course, fourth course and fifth course. So all are arranged in a proper course and all the stones are of different sizes and shapes. This is coarsed random rubble masonry. Next one is square rubble masonry. So in this, roughly squared with straight edge and sides. See, normally if you take a stone, it will be having six sides. The bottom is known as bed and it will be having front, back, right and left sides and a top. So in this, the stones are roughly squared with straight edges and sides, and this will be hammer blown. And in this again we have two subdivisions, uncoarse square rubble masonry and square rubble masonry. So we know that if it is an uncoarse, it will be in a zigzag pattern. So height will be different height, but edges and sides will be straight. In coarse rubble masonry, we all have been having the same height. So this is the uncoarse rubble masonry. See, all will be of a square or rectangular stone. And this is not having a proper coarse. So this is uncoarse. And this is having a proper coarse. Coarse 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we have square and rectangular stones. So next one is polygon rubble masonry. It is hammer finished, irregular polygon shape. So just kindly tell me, how many sides does a polygon have? If you said 5, then what about pentagon? Pentagon will be having 5 sides. See, polygon means it is a plane figure. It is enclosed by a many straight lines. So it can be 3, 4, 5 or more. So triangle, square, rectangle, pentagon, hexagon, everything is a polygon. So the rubble masonry, which is made of many polygon shaped stone, are known as polygon rubble masonry. Obviously, we can't classify this in coursed and uncoursed, because polygon will be different polygons, so this can't be arranged in a course. So this will be only in uncoursed polygon rubble masonry. So the next type is Aslar. What we saw till now is the random rubble masonry. Now what we are going to see is Aslar masonry. See, Aslar masonry, in the sense, the stones are in a proper size and shape. So in this we have 5 subdivision: Aslar fine masonry, Aslar rough tooled masonry, Aslar rock masonry, Aslar chamfered masonry, Aslar facing masonry. So Aslar fine masonry, in the sense, the stone is cut in proper size and shape, and it is arranged in a proper fashion. The next one is Aslar rough tooled masonry. So in this they have mentioned rough tool, in the sense, so in this type the stones are properly chased in the bed and sides, but the faces is rough tooled. So that is the second one. And the third one is Aslar rock masonry. In this Aslar rock masonry, everything is rough tool, whether it is a bed, side or face, everything is rough tool. If you see the mortar thickness between the rocks, in Aslar rough tool masonry, it will be less than 6 mm. In Aslar rock masonry, the thickness of the mortar will be less than 10 mm. And the fourth one is Aslar chamfered masonry. Chamfered is nothing but beveled. In the sense, if we have a rock in the peripheral part of the rock, it will be beveled. In the sense, the edges will not be sharp, it will be little bit curvy. So that is known as Aslar chamfered masonry. And the last one is Aslar facing masonry. The Aslar facing masonry is the combination of rubble and Aslar masonry. So we have 5 subdivisions. We'll just look into Aslar fine masonry in detail. So Aslar fine masonry, it is very costliest stone masonry. Fine chisel dressed on bed, sides and faces of the stones are done. Height should be more than 30 cm for the each stone, and mortar joint thickness should be less than 3 mm. So this is the Aslar fine masonry. See, we have a stone which is properly dressed, and if you see the joints between two stones, this is known as the mortar thickness. It should be less than 3 mm, and the vertical joint is scattered. See, if you want to compare this with our bricks, so this is almost similar to the English bond. We have a header course, we have a stretcher, it will be alternating, and these are the mortar joints, and the vertical joints are staggered. So this is all about the stone masonry. But in current scenario, we will not use the stone masonry, because the shifting of material takes time, it is heavy, and dressing of stone is difficult. So currently we are using stone brick masonry only, but in some case we will be using stone masonry. Just tell me, while constructing our house, only one small part we will use the stone masonry. Just comment it below where we are using the stone masonry. That's all. Thank you.